Well, a lot of people want to see our version of the Dallas song, like from Sesame Street, and all those sounds and things. But check out this footage we shot this week today. So, watch this.
Tell me now, have you ever seen bananas growing a banana tree? You may see two and you may see three, but you never see one alone. Let me tell you now, one banana, two banana, three banana, four banana. You may see two and you may see three, but you never see one alone. Tell me now, have you ever seen bananas growing a banana tree? You may see two and you may see three, but you never see one alone. Let me tell you now, one banana, two banana, three banana, four banana. You may see two and you may see three, but you never see one alone.
Okay, right off this week's show, we got a great special treat for you. I've heard stories about the BP oil spill and all that. Well, actually, see that darkness was spread across the land and all that. But thank, like, I mean, one of the things we have, like, we have four earthquakes this year, two volcanoes and Iceland erupting, and an oil spill. What next? Our own nuclear missiles turn against us? Well, actually, it seems that when darkness was spread across the land, Lone Voice actually said, yes, we can. Actually, this is actually the biggest oil tanker that's actually going to suck up all the oil off the things. It actually comes with the solution to the oil spill to suck up all that oil. This ship can actually withstand a lot of storms. It believes that it has a lot of nerve, a lot of drive. So, let me check out this footage.
Pilot boat, it is immediately clear. This is no ordinary tanker. It is immense, the size of almost four football fields, and there's a reason why they call it a whale. These are its jaws. It is a massive ship designed to consume far more oil-tainted water than anything else on the Gulf. Senor Radhakrishnan captains the vessel.
I have been in this career for 16 years, and I've been done only oil tankers. And to do something different, it always, you feel good. You feel really good about it, and something for a good cause, nothing like it.
The Associated Press was the first news organization to tour the ship once it arrived in the Gulf on Wednesday. It's anchored near the mouth of the Mississippi River, while the 36-member crew await clearance to deploy to the spill site. The 10-story high tanker was built in South Korea for a Taiwanese shipping outfit. The ship was designed to carry oil and iron ore, but soon after it was built, days after the Deepwater Horizon explosion, its owner decided to alter it to skim oil. Shipbuilders in Portugal cut 12 vents in the ship's bow.
What we receive in the receiving tanks, it's a mixture of oil and water. I mean, we are presuming something around, say, 15 to 20% of oil in that water.
The mix will be distilled in separate tanks on board. Water will be pumped back into the Gulf from the stern, oil pumped to collection boats. The ship can suck up far more oil than any other vessel working the cleanup. It can also withstand very rough seas.
We do normally skimming during the daylight hours, and the nighttime we utilize it for the decanning part. So we have a great capacity of more than 50,000 cubics, which is more than about 300 to 350,000 barrels, depending upon the weather conditions.
Members of the crew and officials from the company that owns a whale will be meeting with Coast Guard and BP officials in New Orleans on Thursday. They hope to come out of that meeting with permission to begin operations at the spill site. Jason Bronis, the Associated Press, along the Mississippi River.
Wow, wasn't that amazing? Wow, what about that oil tank? What about that oil skimmer, huh? Was that something big, huh? I hope it actually works. I hope you actually get clearance. Anyway, so here, it seems that actually goodness is going to happen. So basically, when darkness was spreading across land, Lone Voice actually said, yes, we can! It's going to be great and amazing. I hope to get that oil spill cleaned up. So here's to the brave people out there.